good to eat. Yes, we have it every day. We sing this song, it will make us strong, and it makes us shout, hooray! It's good for growing babies and grown-ups too to eat. For all the family's breakfast, you can't beat cream of wheat.
Cream of wheat, great American family cereal, presents Let's Pretend. Well, hello, pretenders. Well, thank you for that great big welcome. Doggone, we got an echo.
Everybody's in the act today, Uncle Bill.
And we're glad of it. Sybil, what's our story?
The all-time favorite of all the years, Uncle Bill, Cinderella.
The same as the records we can get at the music store?
Exactly like it, Uncle Bill.
And Arthur Anderson says how we travel.
Well, on a brisk morning like this, what could be sweeter than a brisk gallop through the park?
Well, fine, Arthur. Give every man a horse he can ride, and away we go. One, two, three. All right, girls and fellas, head straight for Let's Pretend. Turn left for the story of Cinderella. Let's go!
Once upon a time, a cruel woman married a man she didn't love. Then, demanding that he journey far away to increase their wealth, she took her two heartless daughters and arrived at her new husband's home, where, until then, only love and gentle consideration had been known.
Now, girls, before we go in, here's what we'll do. The first thing is to put this daughter of his in her place.
You're right, Mother.
And the sooner, the better.
She'll soon find out who's running this place. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I certainly am.
Remember, don't waver an inch.
Oh, how do you do? You're my new mother and my two new sisters. Do come in.
Thank you.
Father wrote me that you would arrive today. I'm so very happy to welcome you here. May I call you Mother?
Indeed you may not. How ridiculous.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say anything that would offend you. I only wanted to welcome you to our house.
Your house? Please remember, girl, that from now on, this isn't your house, but ours.
Of course. Whatever we have is yours, too, from now on. Are you Flora or Isabella?
I'm Flora, but Miss Flora to you, my girl. Please remember your place.
I shall be so glad to have two sisters. And you are Isabella, aren't you?
I'm Miss Isabella, but don't call me sister. You may help me to dress and wash my clothes if you like, but don't think that we can ever take you into our family, you poor, ugly little thing.
And if she expects to live here, she might as well know she'll have to work for her keep.
I don't understand.
I'm sure that she'll never be anything else but a scullery maid, Mother. She's too ugly and clumsy.
Yes, if she doesn't break all the dishes first. I dare say she'll learn to be useful.
Well, why are you sitting over there on the hearth, simpleton? You'll scatter the cinders all about the room. Look at her, girls. Trying to hide in them, were you? I know your name from now on. It's Cinderella.
Cinderella! Cinderella! Where is that girl? Never around when you want her.
Cinderella! Did you call me?
Certainly. It's time to help us dress for the ball.
I told you to have everything ready for the girls at 8. Where have you been?
I was working in the kitchen.
Stupid. Don't stand there. Get my dress. Start to curl my hair.
Comb mine first. And I want it done beautifully, too. Ah, the prince is to dance with me tonight.
Yes. You'd better do hers first. It doesn't take so long to make me pretty. My hair's easy to dress because it's naturally lovely.
Your hair is lovely. Ah, then so is a horse's tail.
Why? Oh, stepmother, may and I go to the ball tonight? I'd love to see the prince and dance and hear the music. May I, madam, please?
You go to the ball? You, a scullery maid?
Don't make fun of me anymore. Can't you love me just a little?
I don't know. Oh, stop talking and fasten Isabella's dress.
Don't pinch me like that. And don't spill your tears on my gown, either.
I'm sorry, Miss Isabella.
Oh, here comes the coach. Hurry, girls. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Oh, what lovely horses. Look how they prance. Oh, please, stepmother, let me go. If only to watch from a corner.
Certainly not. Come, girls. Isabella, get your fan. Pick up your train, Flora. Come on.
I'll tell the prince that you sent your regards.
You may stand in the door and watch us drive off.
Hurry, driver. We're late now.
Why should they be so unkind to me? Oh, how lonely and miserable I am. I wish I had someone to talk to. Someone who would understand.
Don't cry, Cinderella. You'll spoil your pretty face.
Oh, what a lovely lady you are. But who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother, Cinderella.
My fairy godmother?
One who loves you and understands. And I'm going to send you to the ball.
Oh, how wonderful. But how can you do it? I have no clothes. I have no carriage. How can I go?
A fairy godmother can do anything. Listen carefully and do as I say. Fetch me that pumpkin by the pantry door.
The pumpkin by the pantry door. Here it is.
Put it there in the roadway. Now, do you see this magic wand I have in my hand?
Is it magic?
Of course it is. Watch. I touch the pumpkin, so. And there's your golden coach.
A golden coach? Fairy godmother, how perfectly wonderful. Now, what do we do?
Why, the horses are next, aren't they?
Oh, dear, yes, and we have none.
Get the mousetrap in the cupboard.
Mousetrap in the cupboard. Here it is, godmother. Oh, it has 6 little mice in it.
Open the door of the trap and let them out one at a time. And watch the magic wand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are your 6 dancing white horses.
What beautiful horses. Oh, they're the prettiest I ever saw. They're shod with gold. Oh, fairy godmother, how thrilling. Now what do we do?
Why, we must have a coachman, mustn't we? Can a princess drive her own carriage?
Oh, goodness. But where do we find a driver?
Fetch me that rat trap. By the cellar steps. Is there a rat in it?
Yes, look. A great big fat one.
Splendid. What a jolly driver he'll make. Open the door. Watch.
Good evening, pretty princess. I thought I'd never get here. Where to, m'lady?
Oh, fairy godmother. Now he's a coachman in purple livery. Isn't he fun?
I'm a jolly one, I am. And the best driver in the country. Hey, whoa, you nags, whoa.
Am I ready to go?
Indeed not. A fine princess must have footmen. Cinderella, bring me 6 lizards.
6 lizards, godmother? Wherever will I find them?
You don't know the magic of fairies, do you? Look. They're by the dooryard.
Oh, I see them. 6 huge lizards. I'll get them. Here they are.
Then here we go. Your footman, princess.
Where to, Your Highness?
Oh, look. 6 handsome footmen in gold uniforms, too. Oh, fairy godmother.
Hey, whoa! These horses are getting restless waiting, princess.
Now I think we're almost ready.
But fairy godmother, look at my dress. It's nothing but rags. How can I go to the ball?
Stand still, Cinderella. Close your eyes. Now open them. What do you see?
A dress of creamy white velvet trimmed in ermine.
And your hair?
Silver and crystal roses are twined in my braids. How beautiful.
You look like a lovely silver moonbeam, my darling. No, one thing more. On your feet, tiny slippers of sheerest glass.
The loveliest slippers I've ever seen.
Footman, you see them crystal slippers. Down off the carriage and carry Your Highness to the coach.
At your service, princess.
Now listen carefully, my dear. Go to the ball. But mind, you must return before the clock strikes 12, or your coach will change back into a pumpkin and your footman back into lizards. Will you remember?
Oh, yes, indeed I will. Oh, thank you, Godmother. I'm the happiest girl in the world, and I'm going to the ball.
Good night. Before 12, remember?
Good night, and thank you 1,000 times, Godmother.
I didn't know a girl could be so thrilled and so happy.
Up on the box, Whitman.
Up it is, sir.
Get up, Prince Beauty. Get up, Combat. Get up. To the castle.
In spite of her stepmother's refusal, Cinderella, aided by her fairy godmother, goes to the ball. Everyone, including her two stepsisters, Flora and Isabella, is amazed at the beauty of the unknown princess. And all evening, a handsome prince dances with no one else but Cinderella.
Oh, my lovely princess. May I take you into supper?
Will it give you pleasure, Prince?
It will be the happiest moment of my evening, Princess.
I'm not hungry, are you?
I need nothing more than to gaze at you. Oh, who are you, lovely lady? Why haven't I known you before? What kingdom do you rule?
Let's say the kingdom of pots and pans, Your Highness.
Kingdom of pots and pans? Oh, I never heard of it. Where is it?
Just next to China.
Prince,
and who are these ladies, Prince?
Two of my guests tonight, Your Highness. This is Miss Isabella.
How
and
do you
this
do? We are indeed charmed to meet Your Highness. We are so long to know you, Your Highness.
Thank you. Have we met somewhere before?
Oh, unfortunately, no. I'm sure we would never forget such beauty as yours.
Your pardon, ladies, but I must see the princess for a moment to discuss a matter of state.
Oh.
It's most important. I'm sure you'll excuse us.
Well, of course. We were so happy to meet you, princess.
Oh, yes, indeed we were, princess.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I've tried to avoid them all evening. Forgive me for saying it, but they're rather silly girls.
Yes, I find them so. Now, what's the matter of state you wish to talk about?
The state of my heart, Princess.
Oh.
I frankly confess that I'm madly in love with you. Will you marry me and be the queen of my kingdom? Oh, say yes, Princess.
Your Highness, you can't mean that.
But, lovely lady, I do.
But you mustn't. You don't know me. How would you feel if you discovered I weren't really a princess?
It wouldn't matter in the least. I'd want to marry you anyway. Oh, you're perfect. From your little golden head to your tiny, tiny feet and their beautiful slippers of glass.
Oh, is that clock striking 12?
Why?
Oh, it couldn't be. It is. I must go.
Oh, no.
No, don't. I must. Goodbye.
A moment, please. Don't go, my princess. Page boy, did you see the princess? Did she go this way?
No, sire. Only a very poorly dressed girl went this way.
Boy, you must be blind. Look here.
Where, sire?
Here is her little glass slipper. Right on the castle step. Of course she went this way.
Well, perhaps she did, sire. I didn't notice. I was so excited watching something else. Strangest thing I ever saw.
What was it?
Well, sire, there was a gorgeous coach standing at the castle gate with six prancing horses with plumes on their heads and silver harness. Coachman in royal purple and six footmen were waiting. Then, sire, as the clock struck 12, as if by magic, the horses, the coach, everything disappeared. And from out of nowhere, Your Highness, a pumpkin rolled down the hill, and six little lizards chased six little mice over the rocks. And they were gone.
That's all very interesting, but it doesn't tell me where the princess is. Oh, I must find her. And I will. Page, attend me.
Yes, sire.
Tomorrow we begin the search. I shall call on every maiden in the kingdom. And the one who can wear this little glass slipper will be the one I seek. She shall marry me and be my queen. Tomorrow we start.
Yes, sire. Queens? Glass slippers? Pumpkins? Lizards chasing mice? I think I must be needing some sassafras tea.
Now, don't tell me you can get so much as 1 foot in the glass slipper. If anybody can wear it, I can.
You, with those feet. Ha! You couldn't get your big toe in it.
Is that
Cinderella,
so?
Come here, quickly.
Yes, madam.
Sweep the steps. Clean off the hearth. The place must look spotless when the prince enters.
Is the prince going to stop here?
Of course, simpleton. Haven't you heard?
Heard what?
Didn't you know that the beautiful princess lost one of her glass slippers at the coronation ball the other night?
And the princess proclaimed he would marry the girl who would wear it?
Well, I'm sure it will fit me, so I'll soon be the queen.
Oh, madam, if he should stop here, may I try it on, please?
Oh, don't be silly. Of course not. Imagine you meeting the prince.
In the first place, your feet are bigger than ours. And in the second place, do you think the prince would marry you, a scullery maid, even though the slipper did fit?
You listen to me, young lady. Sweep off the steps and then see that you keep out of sight.
Very well.
Well, go on and get to work.
Yes, madam. Listen.
Make way for Highness the Prince.
Listen.
The prince. He's stopping at the door.
Oh, mother.
Come, daughters. Look, your prince.
Oh, dear. Yes.
Open in the name of the prince.
How do you do?
His Highness the Prince is here. Oh. Have you marriageable daughters that will try on the glass with the
madam? Oh, of course I have. Tell the prince to come in, please.
Very well, madam. I'll tell the prince.
Now, girls, powder your stockings so the slipper will go on easily.
Oh, I'm ready, mother.
So am I.
His Highness the Prince.
Good day to you, madam.
Oh, your Highness. Do come in. My daughters are eager to try on the glass slipper. Here they are. Isabella and Flora. But you met them at the ball.
Heaven forbid.
What did you say?
I said, yes, I did.
Oh.
How do you do again?
Oh, Prince, I shall try first.
Very well. Here, page boy, try on the slipper.
Yes, sir. Now, if you'll place your right foot on this pillow, please, my lady.
Yes.
Then.
Try it again.
Well, I'm afraid it's no use, my lady.
No, don't tell me that. Try again.
All right. Oh, dear.
Ouch. I guess I can't wear it.
Ha, ha, ha. I knew you couldn't. Here, Paige, try it on my foot.
Yes, my lady. All right.
Take it off! Start over again. You put it on crooked.
Oh, Well. I can't.
There.
Ooh.
Isn't it on?
No, my lady. Only over your big toe.
I don't believe it.
You did see for yourself, miss.
Try again.
Well, I can't.
Oh, it hurts. Take it off. I wouldn't have such small feet anyhow.
No, perhaps it's just as well. Good afternoon, ladies. Thank heaven it didn't fit them.
I know what you mean, sire.
Hello. Here's another girl sweeping the steps. Well, good afternoon, little maid. Paige, wait a moment.
Yes, sire.
Little lady, will you try on a glass slipper?
Why, yes, if my stepmother will permit me.
Permit you? I command that you try it on immediately. Here, sit on this cushion. Come, boy, the slipper.
Oh, yes, sire. Your right foot, please, my lady. Look, sire, the slipper fits perfectly.
What?
Well, you see, sire, without an effort, it slipped right on her foot.
Let me look at you, little maid. What? You. You are the princess of my dreams. I fell in love with you. I danced with you at the castle. But then you disappeared. You are the one, aren't you?
Yes, sire. It was I who danced with you. And here is the mate to the slipper in my pocket.
At last I've found you, my beautiful princess.
Not a princess, sire. Just a scullery maid.
Princess or maid, I found you again, and that's all that matters. What is your name?
They call me Cinderella, your highness.
My lovely Cinderella, once more I ask you, will you be my bride and queen and rule my kingdom with me?
In spite of my rags, you ask me to be your queen?
In spite of everything, you're the most precious thing in life to me. Will you say you'll marry me?
Yes, my prince, I will.
Then let the wedding chimes announce that I have found the lady of my heart. Cinderella, the loveliest maiden in all the world, has promised to be my queen.
Pretenders for today were Cinderella,
Marilyn Erskine,
the Prince,
Albert Alley,
the Stepmother,
Miriam Wolfe,
Isabella,
Gwen Davies,
Flora,
Daisy Alden,
the Fairy Godmother,
Sybil Trent,
the Page Boy,
Jack Rhymes,
the Driver of the Coach,
Arthur Anderson.
Original music was composed and conducted by Maurice Brown. These stories are dramatized and directed by Nyla Mack. This is Bill Adams reminding you that if you live in a locality that is not on daylight saving time, Let's Pretend will be heard next Saturday morning, 1 hour later. So consult your local newspaper for the exact time of the broadcast. And remember to eat Cream of Wheat, the great American family cereal. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting Company.